called spirits were sitting inside this man. 2,000 tormenting thoughts caused this man to cut himself day and night. And I was studying the word, and God interrupted my thoughts. And he said, "Yvonne, this man is an example of my church." I said, "What?" I said, "Yvonne, this man is an example of many of my children." He said, "They have gotten past the tricks of the enemy. They know about his natures, lust of the flesh, lust of the eyes, and pride of life. They know about those things, so they're careful to stay away from those things. They're careful about where they put their eyes. They're careful about where they put their mind, their thoughts. They're careful about what they do. They slip sometimes, but they're smart enough to repent. But the enemy's not hitting Mama Jill Christians with that anymore. He's hitting them in the mind. He's tormenting them in the mind." He said, "He's planting a little seed through Auntie May. He's planting a little seed through the boss that says we might be laying off. He's planting a little seed through the doctor who says it might be something. He's planting a little seed through the checking account that says I may not have enough, and I didn't have enough." He's planting a little seed. And so that seed, you begin to ponder on it. And you begin to worry, if I don't have enough, then I might go bankrupt, and I might lose my car, and I might lose my house, and I might lose my children, and I might have to go on welfare, and I might have to go live in a subsidized housing. I might get sick, and I might lose my voice, and I might actually have to have a throat surgery, and I might have to actually not be able to talk, and I might lose my hair, and I can't hear as well as I used to, and I might, because, Auntie Wayne may hit on that. And you marinate on that seed. And that seed becomes a worry. And that worry becomes a tormenting thought. And before you know it, the enemy's got you cutting yourself. Cutting yourself. Cutting yourself. No. I'm not cutting your flesh, but cutting your spirit. You see, you're so tormented that you can't pray like you used to pray. You're so tormented you can't sing like you used to sing. You're so tormented with the cares of life that you can't worship and throw up your hands like you used to worship and throw up your hands. You're so tormented that you don't want to fast because you just don't even care about food because you're just so worried that that might be your last meal. You're so tormented that he's got you cutting your destiny. Cutting your future because you kept your eyes off of Jesus. He said, "Tell him, do like the man did in the tomb. Get your eyes back on Jesus. Get your eyes back on Jesus. Don't sit there and torment and dwell in the throne." He said, "It's time for my church to get